I'm sorry, but I don't want to be an emperor. That's not my business. I don't want to rule or conquer anyone. Gentile, black man, and white. We all want to help another. Human beings are like that. We want to live by each other's happiness, not by each other's misery. We don't want to hate and despise one another. In this world, there is room for everyone. And good earth is rich and can provide for everyone. Greed has poisoned man's souls, has barricaded the world with hate, and boosted us into misery and bloodshed. We have developed speed, but we have shut ourselves in. Machinery that gives abundance has left us in want. Our knowledge has made us cynical, our cleverness hard and unkind. We think too much, but feel too little. More than machinery, we need humanity. More than cleverness, we need kindness and gentleness. Without these qualities, life will be violent and all will be lost. The airplane and the radio have brought us closer together. The very nature of these inventions cries out for goodness in man, cries out for universal brotherhood, for the unity of us all. Even now, my voice is reaching to millions throughout the world.
How's it?
The Olympic motto is Citius, Altius, Fortius. Faster, I, stronger. And athletes have fulfilled that motto rapidly. The winner of 2012 Olympic marathon ran it in 2 hours and 8 minutes. If we made him got in a race with the champion of 1904 Olympic marathon champion, he would have won by nearly an hour and a half. That's huge. An hour and a half. Inexorably progressing. But it's not like we have evolved into new species. Just as such. So what's going on here? I want to take a look at what's really behind this march of athletic progress. In 1936, Jesse Owens held the world record in the 100 meters. Had Jesse Owens been racing last year in the World Championship of the 100 meters, when Jamaican sprinter Usain Bolt finished, Owens would have still had 14 feet to go. That's a lot in sprinter land. To give you a sense of how much it is, I want to share with you a demonstration.